It's summer, it can be tough. Pews are a little less filled. But that doesn't mean that with the pews being less filled, that there's any less life that's going on in our church. As a matter of fact, there's a lot more life that's going on in our Church of St. Mary now than has been in the recent past. You know, a lot of times it's easy for us to say, especially like last fall when we were going through what we were going through, and the bishop sent that survey and asked for our opinions, and people were, oh, well, it's not like it used to be. Well, no, nothing's ever like it used to be. I mean, I can think back to when I was in school at St. Mary's, and we had the bazaars, and we had the dances, and we had the picnics. We had all those great things that were going on. It's because everybody got involved after a while. People got tired, I guess. That's the only reason I can figure, is people got tired. But you know what? Recently, we've been starting to follow these words that we heard St. Paul write to those people, those Romans, all that time ago. If we listen to those words that Elaine read for us today, it starts out, "Brethren, we who are strong ought to bear with the failings of the weak and not to place ourselves, to please ourselves. Let each of us please his neighbor for his good and to edify him." So we come to church on Sunday morning. We come to church so that we can be gathered as a family. We come to church so that we can thank God. We come to church so that we can praise God. So we can give him a part of us, since he's given us so much. But that's not the only reason why we gather. We gather so that we can be strengthened too, right? And what does that strength go for? That strength is to go for us to be able to go out and help those around us who don't have that knowledge, who don't have Jesus in their lives, to bring him to them. We're not supposed to look down on them. Oh, you don't go to church. You're not worth my time. You don't cross yourself the right way. You're not worth my time. No, we're there to help them. We're there to help them find that joy. Because that's why we were put here. Again, we hear St. Paul writing this, and this is why I say it still applies to us. "For what was written in the former days was written for our instruction, that by steadfastness and encouragement of the Scriptures, we might have hope." Now, does that sound familiar? Do we come here so that we can have hope? Yeah. We listen to these words that were written, and we take them to heart so that we know that we're not lost. And as I go back to that idea of the survey that we had in the fall, look at the things that, or think of the things that you put down in that survey. And look at the things that have happened in our Church of St. Mary since then. We could have thought back again, like I said, oh, we had this and had that and had that. But under Father Michael Lee and Father Mark, we had fire stuff. It wasn't maybe the best of weather. We had to dig ourselves out to get here, and then we had to dig ourselves out to get back home on many occasions. But we had Bible study on Thursday mornings and Thursday evenings. Now on Tuesday evenings, we have chant. And when we're here for chant, we don't just sit around. We sit in the church right up here in the front pews. We don't just sit around and open your book to page 72 and we're going to sing this. We learn about why we sing and what we sing. And the things that came before us and the people that came before us. Just as it is here, St. Paul says, take everything that's happened, take what was written, and use that as a guide. So our church is coming alive on Wednesdays. Every other Wednesday, we have our prayer group that meets. The prayer group started out as the Pastoral Plan Council, who started reading the Psalms for the strength of St. Mary's and for the strength of the Byzantine Catholic Church. And it's grown. We've had some folks who have come to me or to Father Mark and said, hey, can we pray those psalms too? And gladly, we got a lot of psalms left. If you want some, ask me, okay? We'll be happy to give you some psalms. And we pray those psalms every day. We pray the same psalm every day. And we get to know it, and we get to learn it, we get to understand it. Well, maybe not totally understand it, but we get to know it better. And then it draws questions. And from those questions, then we find the answers when we come together here on those Wednesdays. So the church is coming alive again. I open the book one more time. May the God of steadfastness and encouragement grant you to live in such harmony with one another, in accord with Christ Jesus, that together you may with one voice glorify the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Isn't that what we're trying to do? Isn't that what we're starting to do? Can you see it? If you come on one of those evenings, you can feel it. If you were there for the Bible study, people... Father Michael Lee would talk for an hour and a half. He was supposed to talk for an hour and 15 minutes or an hour or whatever it was. He'd talk for an hour and a half, and then people would stay around for an hour afterwards. And that light is there. We've got a couple of our cantor singing meetings that they've lasted an hour because we've covered what we needed to cover. And some of them have gone on. And they've gone on. They've gone on because that light is there. That life is coming back to St. Mary's. That life is here. Elaine today, and all the other readers who have been reading, that life is coming back to St. Mary's Church. And in those words of Father Abel of blessed memory, I urge you, and I encourage you to get involved. Lord Jesus.